talk about what it's like to grow up in an alcoholic home. For those of you who don't know, I'll just kind of try to walk you through it. So you're born into a four-person home. You've got an older sister and two parents. And you're just a sweet little boy, and you grow up, and you're kind of like this little island of love, just like most babies are. And you notice that your parents fight a lot. You don't really understand it. You love both your parents, and they seem to love you, but for whatever reason, there's a lot of fighting. You don't really understand it. And you don't know how to ignore it either. It seems like your older sister knows how to, but you don't. So you kind of just absorb a lot of it, try to rationalize it. And a lot of things that you come up with are that there's something wrong with you. And you don't really know where to go with it. Like, you hurt a lot, basically. You feel like you're getting run over by a truck every time your parents fight. And it's a tough spot to be in. So you grow up and you enter manhood, and you're kind of just angry a lot of the time. You're angry at the world. You blame your boss. You blame your friends that fuck you over. You blame, you blame your school and the system. You blame whatever, money. You blame your parents. You don't really know what to do with it. But it's an uncomfortable spot to be in. And you get out on your own, and basically it becomes really difficult because now you're not living with your parents, so you can't really blame them. They're not making you do anything. And you're a man, you can do whatever you want. So you're picking jobs that you don't enjoy, and you have friends that aren't trustworthy, you're not trustworthy, and you have a job that you hate, and you picked it. And when people, when you're faced with the question, what do you want to do with your life? You don't know. You don't know what you want to do. Because that was not something you grew up with. That question wasn't relevant when you were growing up, so you never really thought about it. And really the way you got through your childhood was to stop thinking about what you wanted to do, or stop thinking about what you even wanted, like what do you want for dinner? That's a difficult question for you, because basically your opinion was seemed to be a source of a lot of discomfort, and it may have even started fights, you're not sure, but you think it might have started fights. So you grow up, and you get out, and you mix it up, and you fucking do that right there. And you have a pretty good life, and you think you're having a good time, but basically you hit bottom at some point, and you reach out for help, and then you start getting some hope. Your mom went to Al-Anon when you were 10, and you remember that it was really good for her. Al-Anon is a 12-step program for people that are living with alcoholics. And so you figure you check it out, and you walk into the first meeting, and you're in a room full of middle-aged women who are married to alcoholics, and you don't want to be there because they all remind you of your mom. Shit, you're in that much pain, you stay, and you try to hear it, you try to listen to what they're saying, but you really don't want to. You do some drinking, and kind of fumble your way through life, and you keep going to these meetings, and eventually you start to get the message, and you start to realize that there is, like, possibility for redemption in your life, even though it seemed like the problem was always you. The problem wasn't the situation you grew up in, the problem was always you. That was when you entered manhood. But you keep going to these meetings and you try to just listen, and you discover that you're powerless over the way you grew up, and that it's not really your fault. And it's also not your parents' fault. And that it wasn't fair. It really wasn't fair. And so you start to take a deep breath and realize that life can be a good thing. You don't know what that means yet, but you keep working, you keep going to these meetings, and eventually you start to become trustworthy. You start to make choices about your life instead of backing into everything and doing what other people want you to do. Eventually, I think, you start loving your family, you just kind of move through your life, and eventually you get to the part where you decide that you don't need to understand everything to be happy. And that makes life a lot easier, and you can grow your hair out. And that isn't good or bad, it's just something that you can do because you're white and you reach 25. Okay, it's 25. That's been my experience of it. And basically you're left in a pretty good spot where you don't take things for granted. You've got a pretty good life. You're learning how to love your family. You're learning how to pick the things that you want to do with your life with some intelligence. And you've got a lot of pictures from over the years, most of them recent, of yourself